This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Have you ever set up a domain and pointed to a cloud resource and then deleted the site? Have you ever left behind the CNAME in your domain name services settings? Well, attackers know that we do this. They can then create a site in your subdomain records and take over these sites. As noted by Microsoft, these subdomain takeovers are too common, especially in large organizations that create and delete many resources. CNAME records in particular are open to takeovers. Often these sites are used by malicious actors to redirect traffic and activity to various sites. So how does this work? So you start by provisioning an Azure resource with a fully qualified domain name. You then assign a CNAME up at your DNS zone with a subdomain, such as greatapp.contoso.com. You then deprovision the Azure resource, and you forget that you've left behind that CNAME. So here you have it dangling out there. And what happens is attackers will go through your DNS records and see that you have an open resource like this and set up a brand new site pointing to what used to be your old Azure resource site. There are several resources out there to check and make sure that you don't have these dangling DNS resources. One of them is out on GitHub at getdanglingdnsrecords. Once you've identified a list of vulnerable CNAMEs that are now pointing to assets that are not yours, you'll need to go to your DNS zones and remove all CNAME records that point to these dangling resources. You also need to do a search in any website or application code for any specific subdomains and update any incorrect or outdated references. Keep in mind if you've used any third-party authentication processes such as OAuth, or perhaps passed along any sensitive information such as cookies or anything like that, you may need to perform an additional incident response in order to determine the level of your exposure. Even Microsoft does this. Back in March of 2020, a researcher found 670 Microsoft subdomains that were vulnerable to takeover. So make sure you have in your processes, in your developer processes, the ability to go back and review and make sure that any of these sites have been taken down. Don't just decommission a website, make sure that you take out everything that related to that as well. Back in February, Alan Jones did a presentation at the RSA Security Conference about this very topic, and he talked about some resources that you can use to make sure that you don't do this in your own organization. For example, again out on GitHub, there's OWASP, Amass. There's also Sublister, which is a Python tool designed to enumerate subdomains. And there's also Subover. Now project is discontinued, so you may need to look for other providers of the similar information. Bottom line, you need to understand your DNS environment better and to ensure that developers in your company receive training in basic DNS concepts. They need to know what time to live means, TTL. And you need to reach out to your cloud providers to ask what are they doing to make this problem better so it's not a problem for you in the future. Subdomain takeovers can be a big problem, so make sure that you're not part of the problem. Until next time, make sure you check out the YouTube video channel, IDG Tech Talk. And until next time, stay safe and stay well. This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.